In this video, we're going to talk about core loops, what they are conceptually, and show an example in a real Roblox experience of one that's well designed. A game's core loop is the central gameplay mechanic through which the entire game is built. A core loop can be broken down into three sections: the minute-to-minute player interaction, the most repeated set of actions, and the engine that enables the player to progress. So as an example, a core loop in an RPG would be explore, fight, and upgrade. As you explore, you fight things. After you fight things, you upgrade parts of your character that help you continue to explore and continue to fight. The exploring is the minute-to-minute interaction. You're never not exploring, even if you're revisiting places you've already explored once before. The fighting and the combat mechanic is the most repeated set of actions, and the upgrade system or skill tree is the engine that enables the player to progress. A well-designed core loop fosters a seamless, repeatable, enjoyable gameplay cycle. Now that we know what a core loop is conceptually, let's see a practical example in a real Roblox experience. In Jailbreak, the core loop is explore, complete objective, and power up. This is regardless of what team you're on. If you're with the police, exploring means searching the town for a criminal to detain, completing objective means detaining criminals, and powering up means purchasing weapons and vehicles. If you're with the criminals, exploring means searching the town for a crime to commit, completing objective means committing a crime, and powering up means purchasing weapons and vehicles. In Jailbreak, the police and criminals both have the same progression engine, the purchasing of weapons and vehicles to power up, that then starts another core loop cycle. When you design a core loop effectively, you create engaging and dynamic experiences that captivates players.